Hello, welcome back to Princess Glitterhead. Today I just did this kind of soft but glam look for you guys, and I wanted to show my whole drugstore routine.
Girl, what all that?
What you doing with all that ass? Let me touch you. Though, this is the finished look from today's video. And if you would like to see how I got here, please keep watching. I'm going to show you how I do my whole face, start to finish, using only drugstore products. And a lot of these products are some of my very favorite products, and a lot of them are dupes for other higher-end products. So I will let you know when I get into the tutorial and I have one that I know has a dupe, I will tell you what it is. And if I can show you side by side, I will. The eyebrow pencil that I love from the drugstore is by NYX, and it's called the NYX Micro Brow Pencil. I'm using the shade Brunette, but the shade Ash Brown also works for me. It's a little bit lighter. I just use this one with a lighter hand. The dupe for this eyebrow pencil is by Anastasia Beverly Hills. Put them side by side, they look like this. And if you take the little caps off, they look nearly identical. Nearly identical. So this is the NYX that we're using today, and this is the Brow Wiz that I also love. And I'm in the shade medium brown in the Brow Wiz. Very similar. Even the spoolies feel very similar. It's almost the same product, I'm telling you. It's very similar. The Anastasia is $23 and the NYX is $10. So let's get into the brows. So you have seen me do this before. I slightly just comb them out upwards, and then I start on the bottom and I like to make a very smooth straight line, trying to make all the eyebrow hairs look like they end right there where I made the line. And then I do the other side, and I feel like this has helped me try to create symmetry by going back and forth one thing at a time, the same on each side. So I'm just straightening this out a little bit, making it darker and more defined. And then I go to my tails and I just draw a straight line down. I have found this to be the easiest way to get a similar arch on both sides for me. And then we go to the front, and I start a little further back than the bottom line, and I go up at an angle till I reach that arch. You can always kind of fix the arch later with concealer, so you don't have to worry if it's a little too sharp. And then we do the same thing on the other side, like you've seen me do. You saw me do this in my last video too. And then I just fill them all in, staying darker on the tail, darker through the centers, and then I will use a lighter hand as I get towards the front to make it look like a faded effect. Once the centers are all filled in, I start working my way towards the front, and I just use lighter pressure the closer I get to the front of the eyebrows, and I keep it kind of darker towards the bottom, bringing it all the way in and staying lighter towards the top. And then I just barely touch my brush to make it look a lot lighter in the front, trying to give the illusion that that's, you know, your own natural hair. So you try to use little brush strokes with your eyebrow pencil. And that's all it is, trying to create an illusion. And there's so many different ways to do eyebrows. This is just one of the ways that I found that I like. I feel like it suits my face, and it's just a good shape that I found somewhat easy for me to do, I guess. Don't we all do things that are easier for us? To clean up around my brows, I usually use the MAC Pro Longwear Concealer in NW20, which stands for neutral warm. And so my drugstore options that I'm going to use today are the L'Oreal Infallible Full Wear, and this is probably the shade, this is the shade Vanilla 355. And then I have this Believe Beauty liquid concealer in the shade Ivory, which is from like the Dollar General brand. This one is a little more pink, cool toned. And the other one is more of a yellow. So I'm going to mix them together because I don't really want it to be yellow or too pinky, rosy, because my Pro Longwear, I'll show you the difference. So this is the pinker Believe Beauty one. This is the L'Oreal, more yellow. And then this is my Pro Longwear that I love. It's like my holy grail. And that's right there. So you can see that these two aren't the same. And you can see that my neutral warm one from MAC is neither yellow or pink. It's kind of both. It's neutral but warm. So we're going to mix these two together. Jaclyn Hill brush, which is not drugstore, but it's just the shape. You can find a brush from e.l.f. the same shape. I do have one, and I was going to use it for the video, but I have silicone on it from Halloween still, so we can't really do that. It's just a big mess. So we're not using that one. They do have, some people prefer a little rounded one. This one is the brand Kenzie from TJ Maxx, and you could probably find quite a few options. This is similar. It's small but rounded. I prefer this shape, so that is the one I'll be using. And like in my last video, I'm just going to clean up under the eyebrows and across the tops of them. This just creates an even smoother, straighter line and kind of camouflage any hair that you still have that might be outside the lines like that, just creating more of an illusion that my arch actually goes this high and actually looks this smooth. It's all an illusion, baby. And here we go with both of the bottoms concealed. And now we can work on the top. And this also helps in case one is a little chubbier than the other one, or a little taller or higher. I really do try to be precise with where I lay down the eyebrow color because I don't like relying on the concealer to clean it up. But just going up to the edges of your eyebrows without even having to interfere too much with the color, it just creates that illusion that it's super clean, super precise, and it really has quite a few benefits. It also conceals any redness right around the eyebrows or any pimples or anything like that. I usually touch up around my eyebrows and do any spot concealing around them while I do my eyebrows. And now I work on the center of the eyebrows, and I'm pointing out here that one looks a little thinner than the other, but I usually wait to see how they look after I totally clean up through the middle. So I'm covering up this redness, and then I'm also going to angle my brush just slightly to give each of the brows a little tiny angle. You can make these more squared or more angled. I just like this. I feel like it suits my face better than a very square eyebrow in the front. And then I'm gonna clean up, get really close to the color, clean up around each of them, and then look at them and see if they look even. And this usually does help them look quite a bit more even and helps me get them a lot more even. And then I go through them with a spoolie to blend them.
So the two brushes I start with are by Jaclyn Hill, and they're also by Morphe, which is why I'm including them, because they do have very good prices. They're the JH40 and JH32. One is for packing, one is for blending. And we're going to start with this Essence Beauty. I found at CVS, this palette, Follow Your Heart, it's called. And I'm going to start with White On. And I'm just going to do the highlighting around my eyebrows like I showed in my go-to everyday look. This is kind of something I do a lot for almost every look.
To do a wing because it is my go-to.
I always start on the outside, and then I start with the tail, and I start on the outside, draw it in at an angle, and then straight in and down, if that makes sense, which is what gives that straight across look to the wing, the top part of the wing. And then I just keep going up in layers, making it a little taller, and starting back at the tail of the wing, I bring it straight back in and then angle it back down towards my lashes, if that makes sense. So if I'm building height, I'm really going to the corner every time, making it taller on the outside, and then always just bringing back down towards my lashes. It really just takes practice. All eyes are not the same, and all eyeliners are not the same, so it takes practicing and seeing what you like and what shape works for you. And then I'm just still working on the outside here. Sometimes I need to just fatten it up a little, bringing it straight back in. Almost looks like a diamond on the end, if you can see that. So that when you close your eye, it just has this wing shape. And then I still usually have to clean up with a little wet wipe. And I figured I would show you the other side in case you didn't see the first one, bringing it straight down at an angle. And then I start at the outside, bring it straight in right there and down. I'm trying to explain it. It is kind of hard, but once you get the hang of it and you start doing it yourself, you'll be able to do it almost the same way every single time once you find what works for you. And then I just fill it the rest of the way in. I'm fattening that one up a little. Whoa! Now look at yourself in the mirror and think, holy crap, who is this goddess? Damn. Yeah. need to stop right now. Call it a day. I added some holographic eyeshadow to my lid and below my eyebrow with the NYX holographic palette that I did not show in this video.
Maybelline Tattoo Studio for my tight line.
I didn't show the NYX holographic palette because I wasn't really impressed with the payoff, so we'll keep looking for a good one. Lashes are Splendor by Kiss. I did forget that I don't have an eyelash curler from the drugstore, so this one is by Tarte, but you can use whatever doesn't pinch your eyes that you like. And I grab my lashes at the center with a pair of tweezers, and then I stick them down to the center of my eyelid first. And then I tuck each of the ends under and down. Hold it for 1 second so it sticks. The tackier the glue, the easier this will be. Don't try to put them on wet.
My go-to when all else fails are these wings. I'm gonna show you how I do my foundation using only drugstore products. So the next thing I do is my NYX Angel Veil Primer. And this is from the drugstore. It's a little pricier than like Wet n Wild and some of the other more affordable drugstore brands. NYX products, I would say, are a little pricier. It's maybe more comparable to like L'Oreal's pricing, because this is like $16-$17. But if you get like a primer from Sephora or like a really good name brand primer, you're going to be paying $30 or $40 anyway. And so, I mean, this is a great primer. I'm surprised it's actually drugstore because it does feel and perform more like something high end. So I just go put this on my face in different areas that I know need more help, I guess, because this really will, it'll blur some of the lines and like wrinkles, fine lines. It will help fill in any spots that I have scarring. And it will just help it be like a very even, smooth canvas. The other thing I like about it, though, is I feel like once I really blend it all in, it actually makes my skin look better without makeup, like before I even do my makeup. So you guys can be the judge of that. But I feel like it helps camouflage even some of the redness, and it makes it look really smooth and kind of like mattifying effect. But wherever I have dry skin, like around my nose, this doesn't catch onto it. It doesn't like grab it and then stick onto it. Like other things I've tried will actually stick to the dry spots, and the primer will kind of collect around the dry spots, not smooth them out. And then when you try to put foundation over it, you see all the foundation and primer kind of all just clumped up together, and it's not a good look either. So I really like that this goes on even over my dry spots, and it doesn't make them look drier. It actually smooths them out, makes my whole face look like I have perfect skin. And a lot of it is this primer. I swear my skin looks better already just with that primer. Maybe it's because it takes down the shine. Maybe it's because it makes it smooth. I'm not really sure, but it does. And my favorite drugstore foundation, the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation. I'm in the shade Soft Beige. When I started seeing people raving about this, saying how good it was, I almost couldn't believe it because it's Wet n Wild and it's like $5. So I was like, nah. And then I saw even more beautiful people like doing their makeup looking fantastic and their skin looking perfect. And when I found out this was the foundation, I was like, whoa, okay then. All right, shorty. So then I had to try it. And the first time I tried it, I was freaking impressed. So, and I'm using it with a Real Techniques Beauty Blender sponge. If you're not familiar with the sponges and you're a brush person or a hands person, I strongly recommend trying these out this year. You want to get it nice and wet, and then, you know, it's like a sponge, so it expands and then it gets really big. And then you squeeze all the water out until it's not dripping anymore, and then it's ready. This is one of the keys to a flawless application of foundation. It's a game changer. A brush, there are brushes that you can use, and I do use brushes sometimes. But honestly, that the Beauty Blender, it's hard to walk away from that because it works so well and gives such a beautiful finish to the face and makes it so easy. It's really hard to want to use anything else, honestly. It just really, I forgot to put the hair back. but it just really spreads it out evenly, makes it look like skin.
Maybe we'll get a clip for the hair. Yeah, right about now.
So basically I put spots all over my face, and then I'm going to just tap this. This will be tapping, not rubbing. It's like bouncing off my face. You literally just bounce and like maybe a very tiny little swipe in action. I do one full coat like this, not worrying about spots that you might be able to see through, because after I get a nice even coverage all over, then I will go back over with a second layer. I actually do have quite a bit of redness on my face, just different spots of my face. Like, it doesn't, my face doesn't always match my body, but this foundation does. I only really blend the foundation down like this far. If I feel like I need to blend more, then I'll use my face powder and bronzer. I'm going to go back over certain areas where I see that I still need some coverage. Found that works the best for me. And if I really, really have a bad zit, sometimes I have to go over it one more time, like a third layer, but we're not doing like two whole layers all over our whole face. I'm just doing one layer that's pretty light, regular layer, and then I just go over the areas that really need more. Next, I use the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Dark Circle Eraser, and it's in the shade Light. This is Holy Grail status concealer. It's amazing. I probably could have used this to clean up my eyebrows today, but I didn't think of it.
But I make this triangle shape. This might look like a lot. This concealer is perfect, and it won't feel like a lot. It doesn't look like a lot, and it really, I mean, it doesn't look like a lot once it's blended into your face, and it blends super easy. Super easy. Like, it's, it just melts right into your face. It's amazing. So we're gonna put that down my nose, keep his bow around my mouth where I have darkness, my chin, and between the brows, just like that. And you can tell that's brightened me up significantly. And then we'll blend that in. I like that this is so easy to blend. Like, let's see if you guys can tell. So I use the flat side for this, and I just start patting it in.
Gonna set with Airspun translucent extra coverage, or bake you could say, but I don't consider it like a heavy bake, you know, because I've seen other people, you can put a lot more bake. I mean, it's really just personal preference. And I just get a little bit in the lid and dab it in there, and then I kind of tap it off and make a mess, and then I just press it right in here. This Airspun powder has its own kind of unique smell. So if fragrant smells, like cosmetic smells, if they bother you, or, I mean, it just reminds me of like a powder smell now, or like my mom almost, because my mom probably used this. A lot of people like how it smells, but it does have its own kind of smell. So if you're not somebody into the smells, you might not want this powder. But it does do an amazing job setting and baking and brightening. It's supposed to be translucent, but you can tell that it has a little bit of color. Just enough to give a little more coverage and make things light looking, because you want it to stay light looking. And then I set my nose just because there's a lot of pores on your nose, and I used to have a problem with my foundation not staying on my nose, and I found that by setting like this, it really helps. My favorite face powder from the drugstore is the Dream Wonder by Maybelline. Mine's a little bit broken, but I still use it. I'm in the shade 40 Nude, and I'm going to use it on this big Wet n Wild fluffy brush. You can get these Dollar General, Walmart. They're like $3, and it's a really soft, nice brush. I really like it. So this is what I'm working with, and I'm just going to tap it all over. And this does, this is just a face powder, but it does give a little color back into the face, which is nice, if you can tell. It's adding a little bit of a nice kind of tan color. Just because my face really doesn't match my body. Like the rest of my skin is kind of, well, it's just not, it's not blotchy and red, and it doesn't get zits like my face. So, you know. Some people have like a perfect complexion, even without makeup. Not me. So after I tap it everywhere, I'm going to blend it all the way down my neck, even though like it's just a face powder, but it will help just to blend things and keep them all cohesive. For contour and bronzer, I'm going to use this new palette I just got. It's by LA Colors called Shape It Up Sculpt and Contour. And I'm going to use this contour shaped brush. It's a mermaid handle, probably got it on Amazon. It's not expensive. And I'm going to use the darker one first and do my contour, which honestly, I really don't do anything too crazy. I just swipe it up about halfway to my mouth, up to my ear. Kind of circular motions.
Nice little palette though. I actually have used it quite a few times, and I actually really like it because usually I use my MAC palette. But I found another palette that I'm going to show you guys that is similar to the MAC one. It does have a lot of options for bronzers, blush. Well, it has a couple blushes, and then it has a couple highlights, but it's got a bunch of contour shades. And I'm just going around the outside of my forehead, which will kind of just gives it a shadow there and helps it not look too big. I still use this big old brush, and I just go straight down my nose like that on one side. And now the way that I concealed it and set it with the air spun, it kind of already helps to begin a shape, like to begin a contour of the nose, just because I already highlighted down the center of it, and everything just kind of, you know, just comes together. And I'm not doing anything crazy. I'm literally just going down in a straight line. It's all an illusion. And especially in pictures, it really makes a big difference. Like, my nose looks a lot better in pictures. So that's that. You can also add a little bit under your lower lip. It just helps it be a little more pouty looking. Not too much. You don't want it to look dark. And then after that, I take this other brush, which is really cool looking. I think I just got this on Amazon. It wasn't expensive either, but I don't know the name. I'm really sorry. The brushes,
you really don't have to spend a lot of money on brushes. You don't have to, but you will find some good online brands like Morphe, ColourPop, Sigma used to be a good one. Doe Color. They have some really good ones. But there's a lot of really inexpensive brush brands now that you can find a whole set of brushes, like a whole set of eye brushes for really, really, it's really affordable. It may not be like drugstore, but I've gotten a lot of my brushes over the years just from picking a couple up here and there. And so they're all mismatched, different kinds. It's hard to get drugstore, like just drugstore brushes. You can, like the Real Techniques brand is good. Milani has some really good ones. Wet n Wild has their own. Probably all the brands have some, but if you're looking for like detailed eye brushes and different shapes and different sizes of brushes, your best bet would be to find somewhere online that has good prices and good quality brushes like Morphe, Doe Color, those ones that I mentioned, and just order a set. Usually they have coupon codes for people or around the holidays and stuff, but they're really affordable, very comparable to drugstore, but really good quality.
I'm gonna use this lighter one now with this fluffier one, and I'm just going to blend around what I already did.
And I think my daddy's home. What? Yep, that's daddy. So I'm just going to blend this out like that. All right, for blush, I'm gonna try something I haven't really tried much. This is the LA Colors Highlight Contour Blush Palette. And it has quite a few. There's two blushes. I was thinking, I'm not really sure. I wanted to see if the pink one would show up. So I'm gonna use this brush. I think it's by Sigma, which is like from a couple years ago. But it's a good blush brush, and no other one has been quite as good, so I use the crap out of it. And that's this light pink. And this was like really very affordable. Wasn't expecting much out of it, but I do like it quite a bit. One a lot of people have talked about, it's Wet n Wild Mega Glow Precious, what is it called? Well, it doesn't even say on the back. No, but it's a goldeny one, and it reminded me of MAC Soft and Gentle, which is like my favorite one. So I'm going to see. We're going to see how it goes. I like to use my blush brush, and I just put it right on the top of my cheekbones. Little on the bridge and the cupid's bow. Like that. All right, I'm gonna go put my lips on.
Using NYX waterproof retractable liner in the shade Nude, and I just go around the outside of my lips first, and on the top I slightly overline them, and I will probably do a separate video that is just dedicated to lips, but I do have a lip video on my other channel, my Glitterhead Dental Diaries channel, so if you want to check that out, I will link my other lip video in the description below for a little more detail. And then I just fill them in.
Man, all I gotta do now is wipe off under my eyes just in case there's like any extra bake. But this is the finished look. I'm just gonna set it with the Wet n Wild Natural Finish Photo Focus Setting Spray. Actually, spray it a couple times. Make sure it's coming out good before you spray it the first time, because sometimes it's like total just water droplets everywhere. It still felt a little wet. Ooh, it's like a shower. I kind of like it. Whew, anyways, all right. The lip is kind of just natural, but light. So I feel like it's an overall kind of light glam vibe, you could say. But yeah, this is it. Thank you guys so much for being here, and thank you for watching. If you want to see more videos like this, make sure you subscribe, turn your notifications on. The links to all my other channels and social media things will be down below. And other than that, thank you so much for watching. Have a wonderful day.
As always, thank you so much for watching. Please check the description for all my links, and don't forget to subscribe. I love you.